Hello dear students, the topic of today's lecture number 9 and 10 is called a database system. The question that we will consider on this topic are as follows. The first question, basis of database systems. Concept, characteristic, architecture. The second question, data model, normalization, integrated constraint on data. The third question, query tuning and their processing. Fourth question, fundamentals of SQL, parallel processing of data and their restoration, design and decision and development of databases. Technology of programming ORM, the distributed parallel and heterogeneous databases. What are databases? A database is a structured collection of records or data. A computer database is a kind of software for organized data storage. Database will help you organize this related information in a logical order for easy access and search. Several models are used for database development, such as this is hierarchical model, network model, relational model, object-oriented model. Now let's focus on each of them separately. Hierarchical model, this is presented in a hierarchical model that is organized in an inverted tree structure. It can be represented in the form of such a scheme. This structure organizes various data elements in a hierarchy and helps you establish local relationships between data elements in multi-type files. Each unit in the model is a record, which is also called a node. If you look closely, is it noticeable that each record in our cycles has one parent? The second model is called network model. The network model tends to store records with links to other records. Each record in the database can have multiple parents, meaning the relationships between data elements can have many relationships. Thus, this model is an extension of an hierarchical structure that allows many-to-many relationships to be established in a tree structure that allows for multiple parents. Here we see that the network model provides a greater advantage than hierarchical model in that it provides greater flexibility and data availability. The third model is a relational model. In the lower form, the table is shown in the upper row by columns number in order, last name, first name, patronymic, date of use, registration number and crop. This is the records number, surname, last name, first name, date of birth, registration number, crop. This is relation model, relation model of database management, relationship-based database model. The basis data structure of relation model is a table where information about a specific entity is a cell a student is a represented in columns and rows. Columns list various attributed as characteristic object, for example, student name and date of death, registration number, and group. String, also called records, are instances of an object, such as specific student. This is specific student, this is surname, last name, date of birth, registration number, and number group. DFO model is called object-oriented model. In this model, we have to discuss the functionality of the object-oriented programming. It provides full future database programming capability while containing native language compatibility. It adds the database functionality to object programming language. Its operation is analogical in the application and database development into a constant data model and language environment. Applications regularly code use a more natural data modeling and code bases are easier to maintain. Object developers can write complete database applications with a decent amount of additional effort. But object-oriented databases are more expensive to develop. The second question, data models, normalization, integrated constraint on data. A data management system is a computer software designed for the purpose of managing database based on a variety of data models and a complex set of software programs that controls the organization storage management and the retrieval of data database. Data management tasks fall into one or four general categories as in the below. Entering data into the database. Housekeeping tasks such as updating data, deleting obsolete records and backing up the database, sorting the data, arranging or rearranging the database records, obtaining subjects of data. There are several advantages in DBMS such as reduced data redundancy and inconsistency. And train the data improved security. Normalization of data is a process of transformation data kind answering the normalized forms. Classification of limitations in integrated limitation of database keep variable limitation of attributes, limitation of types, query tuning and zero processing. Query tuning the DBMS SQL component with the final navigational physical, the navigation logic, the sequence, process, the user query optimizer, fundamentals of SQL parallel, data design of database process, creation of the database scheme, determination necessary, integrated constraint. Main objective of decision of database, support of storage, the data acquisition possibility, abbreviation of redundancy, support of integrated database, main decision stage of database, conceptual decision, and most often logic decision, and physical decision. ORM object relational mapping, systems programming allows, etc. Distributed database, heterogeneous systems, question and study. What makes database a decent component of modern lab? Can database be used predict consumer behavior? What is the normalization? What is the data models? What is the integrated constraints on data?